Hello again, welcome back to another show. This should be the fun show. This time we're talking about 3D films and what I think are the best 3D films. Doesn't mean they're the best films, the best films with 3D in them. You know, the recommended ones from this genre. Sometimes because 3D is really good in the film. Sometimes the film's good with decent 3D, just depends. But I'm just trying to cover the 3D films I would say go see for different reasons. It was kind of inspired by, because Daisuke Beppu talked about Jaws 3D and I'd seen that film in 3D. I thought, I was going to do a bit of 3D video a while ago and I forgot all about it. So here it is, finally. So I'll talk first about the 3D started in the 50s and there's a few good ones that are really worth seeing. There's House of Wax, a Vincent Price one, that was directed by Andrew Dutour through his only one eye. He made one of the best 3D films ever, which is very odd. Now, House of Wax is not the greatest film. I mean, it isn't the greatest plot, but it really works. It's an enjoyable Vincent Price movie, especially in 3D, where it just delivers it what you want. The atmosphere in 3D in this film was just wonderful. I watched it in a PSVR thing where it's always like seeing the cinema in 3D without the glasses. And it just... the atmosphere was just beautiful in it. It's just really enjoyable. It's got this wonderful sense of purpose with the 3D. It understands the space and it just really works in 3D. So I'd highly recommend that one for 3D. You've also got two Jack Arnold films, Creature from the Black Lagoon and It Came from Outer Space. It Came from Outer Space is a alien invasion movie that's not quite what you think. It's the aliens have it up to their own, have their own idea of what they want. I'm not going to say what they're about. It's got a kind of Invasion of Body Snatchers feel to it in certain areas, but it's more interesting than that. I bring it up as a shot in 3D because the 3D landscape is great in this film. You really enjoy it because it's done by a director who understands 3D, understands where the camera should be. That it's not a medium where you just throw stuff at the screen, it's about the atmosphere. It's an atmospheric thing where a camera floating high above someone in 3D creates this feeling that you can't get in any other medium and you can't really get in 2D. It's a different feel to it and he's a director who understands that, the tangible difference of feeling. I think 3D will come in a lot more once I've worked out how you have it on just a normal image, you know, that doesn't feel you need glasses for. Then you'll probably find new ways to do it properly. At the moment it feels a bit weird to you. Creature in Black Lagoon is, and Revenge of the Creature Act are both Jack Arnold films in 3D that are both really well done. They both have a wonderful sense of environment and atmosphere. I mean, Creature works so much better in 3D than it does in 2D. 2D is a really well made monster film, and 3D is a beautiful atmospheric experience. You know, it's more of like a fairy story. And the underwater 3D is beautiful. The underwater 3D stuff is wonderful. Yes, the director understands the medium of 3D, of what it is. It's how someone floating 3D actually, it's just, that's enough sometimes. And just let someone enjoy it for like half a minute and then you can get on your story. And it's how you frame the shot. It's just about craftsmanship. It's how this multi-dimensional arena can actually create an environment that actually is worth being in, rather than trying to wonder what's the trickery, how do I deal with that kind of trickery. It's just something innate in Jack Arnold to understand that and see what Andrew Dutoff. The next film I'll point out is from the modern times, Avatar, which is the James Cameron, and he's another director who understands that for 3D. It's like, it's not about the gimmicks, it's about the atmosphere. Like, he seems to, I got the theory that he saw these Jack Arnold films in the 50s and understood what they were and what the potential was of the medium that was never really being used properly. Because there's lots of good 3D stuff in like IMAX as well, where it's about the environment, it's not about the show-offy stuff. But Avatar, I mean, Avatar's a very basic film plot-wise. I mean, it's not complicated. But I defend it though compared to most people's because it is much more like something like King Kong or something where it's about the atmosphere, it's about the world, it's not about the plot's there, but it's meant to be a bit of a primitive film. It's not meant to be a sophisticated film, it's a primitive film. and you should enjoy it in that level. Don't try and intellectualise it to be something it's not. It's a primitive movie. That's what I enjoy about it. It's primitive. It's not... It's a really cool special effects, but it's done for a very basic reason. It's about being in this world and enjoying the world, enjoying this atmosphere. And I really enjoy it for that. So, but especially seeing 3D, I saw it in 3D IMAX, I first saw it, and it really works there. It doesn't work as well anywhere else. You know, other places you can, some of the dialogue can get a bit grating, but in 3D experience, it really makes it work well. But Avatar's kind of animated, so there are other animated films that are also in 3D that are also worth seeing, like Beowulf, which is Robert Zemeckis' one. Zemeckis made Polar Express, which kind of worked in 3D, but it's as more enjoyable in 3D than 2D, but it's still a film that's a bit weird. I kind of like Polar Express, but it is a kind of weird film. And A Christmas Carol, which is the kind of weakest of the three of his, I think, because I think it's too short. It needs a bit more space. But Beowulf's the best one. Beowulf's one of the most balanced because it's the story of Beowulf. And it allows them to cast Ray Winston as Beowulf, so you've the personality of Ray Winston, but with the body of something as much as animated as someone else. And it becomes this thing of the animation and performance capture creates this sense of reality through 3D of this world that's not real, but not exactly fantasy either. It's something new and different, and I think Beowulf's a lot of fun. I really enjoyed Beowulf. I think it's not flawed. It's flawed, but it's not flawless. Brain's going. But it has this, again, a sense of primitive feeling that Avatar's got, this technology and this kind of motion capture that's quite wonderful in its own way. But it's just not the most obvious thing. I think the reason we look back on it with more affection than they are now, I think because Avatar made so much money, it became a target. Another film that's in an animated sphere is Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs. It's also 3D, which is also wonderful in 3D because this was a pure animated film. This was just purely there to be... It's a bit of a machine that drops, that can actually rain food. So it's a sub-premise, and the 3D just builds the premise up to be something. It just creates the world, makes the world feel bigger and more extension of the story. So it's an immersive version of 3D. It's not there to be thrown stuff at you, it's just there to create this world around you. And that's what 3D does best if you get a director who understands it. And that was good with this film. The directors understood 3D, understood what the possibilities were. They weren't trying to do it again, make it just a way to immerse yourself in the 3D and immerse yourself in this world. And it really just worked. I mean, Cloudy Chance of Meatballs is a good film anyway, but if you can see it in 3D, it adds a little bit to it. Another animated one in 3D is Coraline, which is a creepy little story by Neil Gaiman. It's really well done. It's hard to explain, though. It's a kind of creepy style, but it works really well in 3D. It just delivers this kind of weird, kind of dark gothic tale. The 3D just helps with the atmosphere. It's that kind of film. I don't have much to say about this one because I haven't seen it for a while, but it's really worth seeing in 3D because it's got the kind of... It was built for it and it understands how to use 3D for storytelling. An example of 3D used to throw stuff at the screen that's fun is Spy Kids 3D. It was the third in the series. It's not really worth watching as a film without the 3D though. I mean, the film itself is not that great. But if you see in 3D, you've got scenes of you've got bike chase in 3D, you've got lava chase in 3D, where the special effects are a bit dodgy, but it wasn't 3D because they're meant to be a bit dodgy. They're meant to be a game world that's not the most high-res thing ever. A lot of the jokes are groan worthy, but I saw this in a cinema in 3D and it was a lot of fun. And I've seen it again in 3D and with the glasses on, and it still remains good fun. It's a fun movie, it's a fun, cheesy movie that works for what it is. You know, you have a lot of fun with this one. Just enjoy it, just sit back and enjoy it. It's a big, ridiculous, silly movie. That's all you need sometimes. Big, ridiculous, silly movie. There are other ridiculous, silly movies in this genre as well, which I'll bring up. The ones that are... that they do throw stuff at the screen. They are just silly as hell and a ridiculous spot. You know, they are fun. So, they are worth watching. So you've got Ghost Rider Spirit of Vengeance, which is a really stupid film. It's not a good film, but it's shot in 3D, and it's kind of fun seeing some of the weird 3D they've got on it. It's utter trash. It's complete trash, but I can enjoy it for the trash that it is. I mean, it's just one of those ones. There's another Nicolas Cage 3D one called Drive Angry, which is a lot more fun. It's a much easier film to defend because it is a genuinely enjoyable film. It is utterly ridiculous. It knows what it is. It knows how silly it is. It's worth a look in 3D because it knows exactly what it is. Rob Fitchner as a villain is hilarious. He's almost like a deadpan Terminator, you know. Just utterly, utterly ridiculous. You have a Universal Soldier Day of Reckoning 3D, which is a John Hamm's movie that's one of the Universal Soldier sequels, stars Scott Adkins. It's not the most amazing 3D, but you get to see Kung Fu in 3D, and you get to see action scenes made by a proper action director and proper fight scenes in 3D, which you don't get to see very often, so that's another good one to have in 3D. I'm going to look at my thing here. We've got Friday the 13th 3D, which is full of the screen. You know, what can you say? It's silly, it's enjoyable, it's utterly ridiculous, but it is fun. It's one of my favourite Friday the 13th movies, actually, that one. It's set on a farm for most of it, and it's the one where Jason finally gets his mask, and it's one of the best Friday movies, and it's just ridiculous and very enjoyable, so I'd say try and get that. You can get the 3D version of that on the box sets, so, and even if you don't have 3D TV, you can use the glasses, the red and white things, or the red and blue things. You mean Jaws 3D, obviously, Jaws 3 3D, not a good film, but very enjoyable. I have a big soft spot for that one. You've also got Piranha 3D, which is Alexandre Anja one, which is a lot of fun. You know, it's got a lot of disposable characters getting eaten by Piranha. I think it's actually as much fun as the original. Joe Dante one's a lot of fun, so is this one. They're very different films, though. Joe Dante one has just character stuff and all the rest, but this one is just pure gore and caricatures getting killed. Very different thing altogether. Much dodgier acting in this one, but it's so enjoyable. So those are kind of some of the dodgy ones that I had fun with that are utterly disposable, but they're really fun movies. They're just some films that are really fun that are in 3D and you just can't resist them. Okay, now we're going to the blockbuster 3D kind of thing. I know I've covered Avatar, but that's just one of them. When Avatar came out, they started putting some 3D film, 3D in almost all of the films. I loved it because I like 3D, but most people didn't like it. But you got some good 3D films out of it. It's like one of those things, it's like, it depends who uses it. You're going to get some bad films and good films, no matter what creator it is. So these are some of the better films in 3D you should worth watching. Pacific Rim, it wasn't shot in 3D, but it was converted by Guillermo del Toro for 3D. And the 3D version is really enjoyable. The 3D version, the fight scenes are great fun, because they're not doing the typical thing. It's an atmosphere thing. It's more atmosphere, more suggestive of the world, because these are giant robots versus, you know, small people and giant robots versus big monsters, you know. So you've got a set of scale of people running the bottom of the screen and these monsters fighting each other. It's just, it really works in 3D. It delivers, the scale of 3D really works there. You've got two Spielberg films. You've got Tintin in 3D, which is an animation one. And you've also got the BFG, which is part animation, part live action. The BFG was underrated though, because it is a flawed film. It's a very flawed film. I've already covered it in my Spielberg flawed films thing. But it is enjoyable, and the 3D makes it really enjoyable because you've got this the sense of scale of the little girl with the BFG and the Island of the Giants and things, and how she has to try and survive in that area of the Giants and how difficult it is because of the sense of scale. It is wonderful. I really enjoyed that film in 3D because it's built for 3D. It's one of those films that are built, because Spielberg is a very good craftsman, he can plan ahead and make sure the scale is there and is effective. Even though there's some script problems, he still knows how to make that work. Another case of small people and big monsters is Kong Skull Island. This is a... This and Godzilla are the two really good monster movies for scale. I mean, the second Godzilla has good 3D, but it's not... Because you got good monster stuff. But the sense of scale is not quite as good. And the first Godzilla movie, you get a sense of these monsters are all over the place and who are hanging well over the people. And because Gareth Edwards had a interest in suspense and slowly building up and slowly building the sense of scale, you got a sense of people being almost like ants compared to these monsters. So it made the action more dangerous. In Kong Skull Island, it's just a monster movie. It's just Kong versus monsters on this island, and these people are stuck in the middle of it. And he used the 3D just for effect of the sense of scale, but it really works. The battle scene where Kong first shows up and destroys the helicopters is great. Kong versus other monsters with these people run below them is great. It just generally became a monster. The 3D really kind of gave it a sense of scale that was wonderful. You also have stuff like Doctor Strange, which has the 3D scale in a Sword of Magic. So you get these people doing these within the magic, and the buildings are moving all over the place, and everything's crazy. Your sense of geography is all over the place. So it's one of the few places that uses your sense of scale against you to make you wonder where you're actually standing, and that's part of the point. And when these people run through these buildings that are moving around, and it creates a sense of craziness within 3D, which really works. It's not been done very often. And now 3D's kind of fallen away. It won't be done for a while again until someone else brings back 3D. But Doctor Strange in 3D really worked. It really delivered. It's the best Marvel film in 3D. It's when it really got the idea of 3D and really delivered on it. There are other Disney films that... Disney actually did a lot of good 3D films, actually, when I think about it. You've also got Tron Legacy, which had a sense of 3D of the idea of the world, of these IMAX 3D landscapes. Especially when you go into Tron, because these are basically a fake world. You've got the speeder bike sequences, you've got the beautiful sense of the world that's expanding. It's an immersive thing rather than a gimmicky thing, but whenever they're fighting, the 3D just helps you be involved within the story a lot more. It just feels like it makes this world feel much more impressive and much more dangerous. So it's a really terrific 3D experience in Tron. It is an immersive one. You've also John Carter, which is another immersive film where when you see it in 2D, it's okay. It's an enjoyable film, but in 3D, the cutting technique works better because you get a sense that the cutting's been worked out for... It's almost a musical fashion, the film, where there's highs and lows and everything's been worked out. In 3D, probably filmed to this world, so you have them within... as small people within a landscape of these big monsters and big ships. It makes the highs higher, so when we get to the bits where people are quiet, it gives it more effect. So this kind of cartoonish level makes the world more understandable. And when the world's more understandable, the dialogue and everything else makes more sense. I think in a 2D version, it feels a bit flat and you feel like you're seeing people talking in these CG landscapes, and it doesn't have the same effect. But in the 3D landscape, the worlds feel fuller, and what they're saying actually seems to make more sense in the world. So it just works better. So that's another one world building thing where the world works better because of 3D. And that's where it works best. 3D really works best is the world building. It really delivers the worlds. We've got two more. We've got Dread, which is the 2012. It was shot in 3D, natural 3D. It's a Judge Dredd movie, Carl Urban. It depends who you thought directed it, because you've got the official director, Pete Travis, and you've also got Alex Garland, who is a writer, and who apparently, according to rumour, at least, did a lot of the work on the direction, or took over. I don't know exactly what happened. Everybody, there's different people saying different things, so don't listen to me. But the 3D is terrific. They were a good cinematographer who worked it all out. So this idea called slow-mo, which is a drug that slows your sense of the world down. So that in 3D allows for some 3D shooting that actually works really well. But you've also got the environment of the bigger city one in 3D, and it creates this environment, this run-down city that goes on forever. And then when you go into the apartment blocks, having it in 3D means that the claustrophobia in the sense of no escape just is there throughout the film. It just really works for the film, and it is just a wonderful sense of atmosphere. There's not much gimmicks beyond the slow-mo in this one, but it really gives you a sense of where you are. Also, because one of the characters is psychic, whenever she looks at someone's mind, it plucks into their mind pretty quickly and creates a sense of dislocation that really works. The final 3D film is by Werner Herzog. Didn't expect that, did you? Caves of Forgotten Dreams, this is his only 3D film, and it's about this cave that has a lot of cave paintings from the past, and very few people are allowed to go in it because it's they don't want to ruin the location. They don't want to, because the more people go into any location, the more it's worn down. They try to preserve it, but also they want to film it to actually make so you can be able to see in the film to see what's in there. So Werner Herzog was allowed to go in with a minimal crew. He used 3D because he felt that the experience, you couldn't really get in 2D. So he had this 3D experience of this landscape, of this one place, this cave, and also the landscape around it. And it just makes an immersive experience. The way Herzog likes to make his films immersive, what's the world you're in, what the world of these people are. And it's just wonderful. It's one of the films you really have to try your best to see in 3D if you can, because it really works. I hope you enjoyed this little guide. I mean, don't take it too seriously. It's a little guide of what films you could see in 3D that are good, if you've got access to 3D in any way. These are the ones I'd say are the good ones. There's lots of mediocre ones. I mean, a lot of Marvel films are okay 3D, but nothing great, because director's not that interested. You've got a lot of the Warner Brothers ones, the superheroes there, they're the same, basically. It's like, they're 3D films, but they don't seem to be that immersive. So, the ones I've seen anyway. So I think it's just certain directors are good at them and other directors aren't. It's just, that's just the way it is. It just depends how they see the world and how you can use it or not. So I hope you enjoyed this. I'll be back next week with more videos, but that's me for now. So have a good week. See you later.